So Android 13 beta 2 is actually out, and in this video I'm going to share with you the new changes that Google brought to us, and then what you are going to get when you actually install Android 13 beta 2 on your device, specifically on your Pixel 6. So if you're new here, just give this video a thumbs up, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and then let's just check out what we have right here in this video. So the first change I noticed was within the fingerprint scanner, and I think it's a bit okay now. When you touch it, you feel like you are really touching something, unlike first you need to feel a little bit of vibration before the fingerprint actually unlocks with another vibration. But with this, you just have a single touch and then the phone is actually going to unlock. So that is one of the changes I noticed when I actually installed the Android 13 beta 2. And also, when you go to system-wide search, it's actually not really working still, and then what you see is only apps, and then the settings and other stuff don't pop up when you try searching with a system-wide, unlike beta 1, which it wasn't really working at all. So I think Google is actually working something out, and that is basically very cool. And when you go to the Google search right here too, you can see this side right here, it looks a bit thicker than before, and you can see apps popping up in the search bar too, and that was not really there initially. I never saw something like that, but when you go to your Google search, you're actually going to see something like that. And yeah, I think it's not bad, but I really like how it's solid right here, so you can just tap on whatever you feel like you want to search for. Your search history, you searched over there, you can just see it right there, and that is basically very cool. So that is one of the changes too I saw, and that is pretty much very cool. So there were some new widgets too right here. When you go to your widgets, you can now see we have battery widgets right here, which still brings us the battery widgets for our bats and then also our phone, which initially wasn't under battery and widgets, it was in a different section, which was in like the settings widgets or something, but now it has gotten its own dedicated section as battery widgets, and that is pretty much very cool. So I think that is one of the good things too I saw, and Google is actually doing a great job right here. And then also when you check out right here too, you can see the media player having a new redesign, and then also the animation when you just tap on the song to restart it, you can see the animation right here. I really like how it looks, and initially it wasn't really like that. So that is one thing I also noticed right there. And then one thing that came through too was the scan code right here. So right now when you add a scan code to your quick settings, you can tap on it and then it's actually going to open. My beta one, it wasn't actually working on my phone, and when you try scanning something, let's say I want to scan this, and then it picks up the stuff right here, it doesn't really scan whatever you feel like you want to get, it just copies the number or the batch number for the product, and then you are just gonna get to copy it but not to scan it or something. But when you go to your camera, in case you want to just scan this, you can see it's actually going to pick up the number, and then you can scan and get whatever you feel like you want to search, but it's not really working like it. So it's not really getting what you want to get when you even add the scan QR code in your quick settings. So I think maybe that is something Google will actually sort out later in the upcoming updates or before the stable Android 13 comes out. So that is one changes too. And then if you install it on your Pixel 6, I think it's something you are really going to see. So then we are going to go to the dark theme right here, still in quick settings, and then we just press hold on it to go to our dark theme settings. You can see we have a schedule mode right here, which wasn't present initially. Now we have none, and then turns on at custom time, and then turns on from sunset to sunrise, and then turns on at bedtime. So this actually works like the night lights. In case you don't know the night lights, you can see right here it works just like night lights, and then you can just get the schedules right here, and then that is basically very cool. So I think that is one good thing Google has actually added, but a lot of people were complaining it doesn't really work perfectly, but I'm sure maybe Google actually do something better about it. But it's a nice thing Google has actually brought, so in case maybe you want to try it out too, you can just go to your dark theme and then check out the schedule mode, and it's going to be very helpful. And also one thing that was added to was within the battery saver. When you go to your battery right now, battery saver schedule percentage has actually been changed from 5% to 10%. Initially it was just 5%, that was the least battery saver schedule you could get, but now you can just have up to 10%, and then that is pretty much very cool. So I think Google is actually trying to make everything possible for us to get control over everything we want to get, so they are doing it very much easy for us to just get whatever we want. So let's check out the next feature too that came through. So the next changes I saw was within the app settings. So when you go to your app settings and you scroll down to this section right here, you're going to see pause activity if unused. But initially, you are not going to have this option right here. You are actually going to see remove permissions and then free up space right here. But now it's been stated as pause app activities if unused, and that is one changes I also noticed right here. And then you can just check out right here app language, and then you can scroll through to pick any app language you feel like you want. That is pretty much very cool. So in case maybe you are in any country and then you feel like you want to just have a specific language for any app, you can just scroll through. In case you want to just get a different language for flash call, you can just tap on it and then scroll down and then change it right here. And then you want to get a different language for Google Chrome, you can just tap on it and then scroll down to Google Chrome, and then you can just change the language you want to get on Google Chrome. So it's really very great right here. I think Google is actually trying to make people just have control over everything. So if in case you like this feature, just give this video a like and then just check out the next feature. So the next feature too I also noticed was when you try touching on anything on the screen right here, you can see it has a different animation right here. You can see it highlights whatever you touch before it goes to the menu you are supposed to go. And then also when you try going back from a page, you can see that it is slicing from the left to the right, and that is pretty much very cool. So that is one of the changes too I noticed. And then another one you're actually going to see is within sounds and vibration. When you tap on it and then you scroll down, you're going to see we have always show icon when in vibrate mode. So when you tap on it and you're in vibrate mode, you're going to see it right there. And then when you just tap on it right here, you're still going to see that it's going to go off. You tap on it on and off, you're going to see it right there. So you can see right here. And that is pretty much very cool. So that is one of the changes too I saw when I installed Android 13 beta 2 on my Google Pixel 6. And then another thing that I saw too, which was not bad, I think it makes sense right here, was when you try copying something to the clipboard and then you tap on copy and then you try editing it. Initially, we're going to see copy right here, but I was like, Google trying to change this to done makes sense because it's still on the clipboard, and then this states as you are trying to edit something on the clipboard. So when you tap on copy again, it looks like tautology. So I think Google trying to make this thing done, and afterwards when you just add, you're still going to see it added to on your clipboard right here. And that is pretty much very cool. So I think it's one of the good changes Google has actually made, and I feel so great about it. So another feature that was talked about in the Google I/O, which I can see in the settings, is fast pair. So I can see fast pair in the settings right here, but when you tap on the toggle and then you try going back and then coming back, you can see it's going to turn the toggle off. And this one is going to be introduced to allow us to pair a lot of devices very easily, and I think it's going to be one of the game changers right here on Android 13. So I'm sure maybe in future updates Google is actually going to roll this one out. And initially on beta 1, we actually had a chance to search for face unlock, and then it popped up on our Google Pixel 6. But you can see right here in beta 2, when you search for face unlock, you are not going to get any settings or options to tap on to just even go to the settings of the fingerprint unlock settings. But beta 1, we had the chance to just tap on it and go there. So I think maybe Google is actually making some corrections that were supposed to be made on the beta 1, and that is pretty much very cool. So aside that too, I think it's not really bad to install the beta 2 on your device, but I wouldn't really advise to install on your daily driver in case you want to really use, because when I started shooting this video, this phone actually restarted by itself automatically without me not tapping on the restart button or something. It just restarted by itself. So I think it's not really good for you to just install this right now on your daily driver. But if you just have a single device, I'll urge you to just wait for beta 3, and then it's actually going to be a bit stable and you can install it on your device. Beta 1 had a lot of bugs, and you can just check out the video in the description. You can even see the bugs I actually filmed about, and that is really going to tell you that beta 2 is not really okay, even though it's much better than beta 1, because there are a lot of stable features right here. So I'll urge you not to install it on your daily driver. So if this video was very helpful, just give it a thumbs up, and in case I see any changes too, I'm just gonna do a follow-up video for you guys. And don't forget to like the video and then also subscribe to the channel, because I have a lot more I'm going to be sharing with you guys. And without further ado, I'm just going to catch you in the next video. Peace.